Many of us become bound with anxiety, worry, depression, hopelessness. So I want to just give one Bible-based goal in the area of emotions. Determine to find a moment to withdraw from the media, your phone, and people. Envision being with God in a beautiful, peaceful setting, and ask Him to hold your hand and talk to you. Okay, I know that might even sound kind of weird, but I want to unpack this because all of this is biblical. During Jesus' walk on earth, when the pressure was on Him and the pressure was mounting, the Bible said He would often withdraw Himself. Mark 1:35. Very early in the morning, while it was still dark, Jesus got up, left the house, went off to a solitary place where He prayed. And that's just one of a bunch of verses where Jesus would withdraw to a desolate place. So I'm saying, unplug. Find a moment that you can, I don't care if you literally have to go in your closet where it's dark and you shut the door and you don't have your phone in there. I know you can live without it. So don't take the phone in with you. Go in the closet, whatever you need to do to have this like quiet moment with God. Then in Psalms, David talks about envisioning the Lord. Psalm 63:2. I have seen you in the sanctuary and beheld your power and your glory. I believe he in his mind's eye was envisioning God in the sanctuary. This is what I do all the time when I'm trying to hear from God, is I close my eyes and I envision being with Him. And I envision being in a calm and peaceful setting. This is the 23rd Psalm. Psalm 23:1-2. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. That's what I envision. And then this, Psalm 73:23. Nevertheless, I am continually with you. You hold my right hand. So God, you're envisioning Him. First of all, you're withdrawing, right? You're by yourself, you're unplugged. You're envisioning Him in this peaceful setting. Maybe for you it is in a pasture and there's a little bubbling brook that's just, you know, so peaceful. And He's holding your right hand and then He's talking to you. Because in John 10:27, Jesus says, my sheep hear my voice. And I tried this. I'm just going to tell you a personal example here. I tried this just 2 nights ago. I was having a lot of anxiety about something. And I was just like, and you know, have you had that where you're like laying awake at 2 o'clock in the morning going, okay, and your heart's beating, you're like, I think I'm having a heart attack. You're not really, but you know, you think you are. You know, that whole thing, because you're like just so anxious. Has anyone ever wrestled with anxiety? Okay. Yeah, so I was in that moment, and I'm laying there, I'm like, Lord, and I just felt Him saying, okay, remember, I'm with you. And so I thought, okay, I'm gonna do what I'm talking about here. So I just envisioned being with God in this pasture, and there's the bubbling brook, and we're walking together, and I'm holding His hand. And I have to give you a teeny bit of perspective to make this, so how powerful this was for me. I've shared with some of you that I was sexually abused when I was young, and I was very young, and if you're very young, often you can kind of emotionally go away during those times. And I have just now got some of those memories back, but I remember going away when I was a very young girl, like 5, and I was in a meadow, in a beautiful pasture with a bubbling brook with Jesus. And I can see myself twirling around, dancing. I had blonde hair. I really had blonde hair back then. Not dyed blonde hair, just real blonde hair. And I would be dancing around in the meadow, and it was just beautiful. Well, anyway, so go back to 2 nights ago. It's 2 o'clock in the morning, and I'm, okay, Lord, I'm so anxious, but okay, I'll envision being in the meadow with you in the green pasture and bubbling brook. And I heard Him say, Larkspur. And I thought, I don't even know what that is. Now, some of you might know what that is, but I had no idea what that was. I was like, is that a bird? I don't really know. But it stuck with me, and I just knew it was the voice of God, because after a while, you get to know what the voice of God sounds like, or that whisper sounds like. So the next morning, it was still in my brain, so I knew it was like a God thing. So I get up, and I'm like, what is Larkspur? Is it a bird? I don't know. It sounds like a bird to me. And so I look it up online, and the first thing I come to says, this flower grows only in meadows, naturally. And I'm like, and I started to get chills, because they're purple flowers, which is it's that color of flower that was in the meadow where I was dancing with Jesus. And then it said, these are the characteristics believed to go along with this flower. And it listed carefree, innocent, unharmed, pure. I mean, all these words that were just like, I'm still getting chills just talking about. Only God can do those kind of things, right? And it's from quieting ourselves, right? And just coming before him and saying, talk to me, talk to me. I'm envisioning being with you. Hold my right hand, speak to me, Lord. And then just allow yourself to envision being with him. He wants to talk to you. And I know that I know he wants to talk to every single one of you. Believe that he wants to talk to you. Believe that. Have faith that you will hear from him, and you will.